So inside Softimage, if you left mouse button, you'll select the individual. Middle mouse button will select the downward stream. And of course, right mouse button will select the entire hierarchy. Inside of Maya, this is a little bit different. If I select with my left mouse button, I get what looks like the entire hierarchy. If I middle mouse button, of course, that's navigation. And right mouse button is going to be my marking menus. Now the thing is, it's not actually selecting the entire stream. If I go ahead, open up my outliner here, hold down shift, left mouse button on the plus to expand the entire network, you notice that only the top of the node has actually been selected here, each one being selected in turn. If I want to select the entire set, right click, select hierarchy, or select, shift select, or of course, just drag select across the entire set. So I can select all of these guys fairly easily. And the thing is, this has a few distinct impacts. Well, one is, of course, that visually it looks like everything's been selected, but you have to understand that that's not the case. The next, of course, is that this is an indication of inheritance of certain features. For example, visibility. If I control H, I've hidden one object, yet the others are not showing as hidden, but obviously they are. They're not currently visible in the scene here. And that's because of visibility inheritance. So if I go ahead, grab this guy, shift H, and bring it back, you notice that everything comes back. So how is it that I can take this one individual and hide it specifically? If I go ahead and press the down arrow, you notice it still appears selected in here, but only it appears selected. And if I press Control H, it hides. What's happening here is that I'm hiding actually the shape node. I've gone downwards in its stream, but you can't see that here. If I go ahead and display shapes, you can now see that the shape node itself is visible. This is what I've hidden, so Shift H. And there we go. So what other ways can we hide and display items inside of Maya? Well, there's a whole bunch of filters. If we go under display, we've got our show and hide features, and we've basically got the same features in them. We'll just go into the hide. I'm going to click on this bar to expand that. This one and that one. And you can see that there's a whole lot of individual filters that we can use to go ahead and hide any of these things. And we can use these filters in various different ways as scripted features. If you're not sure what the scripted operator would be for that, I can go ahead and say Control Shift left mouse button, and it'll drop it to here. And I can right click on that and say Edit. And what will happen is I will get the command for that. And that's the command that I may need for my script. So there's lots and lots of filters that you can use. Additionally, I also have the visibility here. If I go to the attribute editor, I've got the shape node, and it's got render stats as well as object display, and there's visibility there as well, which of course gives the same impression of just the individual being hidden because it's the shape node, as well as of course visibility here, which does the inheritance. We also have isolate selected, which will basically hide everything in the scene except for the current thing. So I can go ahead and go to isolate selected, which will isolate it, but of course it hasn't isolated anything because all the items appeared selected. They got inheritance here. So again, down arrow, just turn that off, turn it back on again, and it isolates just that individual. So hiding the individual really comes down to that down arrow, and that works for anything that has a shape node. This would include things like, say, a locator, which also technically has a shape node. So you could do that. It's the same as a null in Softimage. And we have one other aspect here, which may come into play, of course, when you start rigging. That is, of course, the joint tool. So if we open up that, we look at this, shift click, you notice there is no shape node for these. So now what? Without the shape node, I press the down arrow, up arrow, I'm just navigating through the hierarchy of the joints. Well, we have this thing over here called draw style over under the joint options, and we have options multi-child as box, as well as this option called none, which makes the joint now hidden and deselectable. The multi-child as joint, if I go ahead and just set that up, if I were to go ahead and just duplicate this, set that back to bone, you'll see that it has two children parented underneath it, and the multi-child gives me a box. So this is fairly similar to the idea of the shadow bones inside of Softimage. It just doesn't have quite as many options, but this is where you would go ahead and hide and show these features. So the last thing that I'll just go through here is one more feature on these guys. So I also have drawing overrides. It's just one more thing that you have available to you. We have templating and reference mode. Reference mode basically means that it's no longer selectable within the viewport. So set that to normal. We also have the ability to, if I just press 4 on my keyboard, if I go ahead and change color here, something like blue, you notice that these have taken on a bluish color, and that also has inheritance as well. So if you only want the individual to pick up that color, remember to do so to its shape node rather than the object node. So if I go back to this and set that back to normal and turn off the overrides and instead move to its shape, and drawing overrides, that one, you'll notice that only that one has picked up that color now. Also, we have display layers, which you're probably familiar with if you've played with them inside of Softimage, and we can go ahead and do visibility for things on that layer, as well as templating and referencing on that as well. And that's all just with left click. And then of course we have color overriding for everything on that layer as well. And as already mentioned, we have our render stats, which is on the shape. And you have things like your primary visibility, visible and reflections and refractions. So that's for rendering purposes as well. So that should cover pretty much everything that you need with regards to showing and hiding features. And hopefully that's been useful to you, and that's all I've got.